the 8-year-old boy had a gun to his head as the gunman threatened his mother for cash. Now, two of those suspects are still on the run, and the boy's mother is dead. Investigators saturate this East Hills neighborhood after an early morning shootout. Officials say more than 40 rounds were fired between Pittsburgh police and three gunmen who were on the second floor in an East Hills apartment. Residents were too afraid to be identified but told our Sheldon Ingram what they saw.
My granddaughter heard the shooting. She said it happened about 4 o'clock this morning. She said it sounded like they was trying to kill whoever they were shooting because they dumped the whole clip.
There was one standing right there where that skid mark is at shooting.
Police say between 3 and 4 in the morning, three masked gunmen invaded 24-year-old Arika Hainesworth's apartment, demanding money as they held her 8-year-old son at gunpoint. They wanted the money inside her place.
So this appears to have been a safe house for drug dealers to store their drugs and possible cash.
Hainesworth called 911. When police arrived, the gunman entered the home. Police say that's when the shootout happened. Hainesworth escaped.
She was able to flee the residence, and at some point when shots were being fired, she was struck in the chest, possibly from an elevated position.
Hainesworth was killed. At this point, police believe it was by the suspect's guns, but ballistics testing is underway. The gunman escaped into nearby woods. Police caught 19-year-old Richard Woodward, who was shot in the torso, likely by police, but tests will have to confirm. Investigators found 43 bricks of heroin inside Hainesworth's purse and one brick inside her son's sock, a combined street value of $52,000. Hainesworth's roommate was shot in the hand during all of this. Her son wasn't injured. Neighbors tell us Hainesworth also has a toddler. Now, police are still looking for the other two suspects. As for Woodward, he is facing more than a dozen charges tonight, including aggravated assault, criminal attempted homicide, and robbery. He is recovering at UPMC Presbyterian Hospital, and police say he is expected to survive. No police officers were shot. Reporting live at Pittsburgh Police Headquarters on the north side, Ashley Hardway, Channel 4 Action News.